The right triangle is a triangle in which two of its sides are perpendicular to each other. In this case, we do have a triangle here on the left side of the screen, and we can see that two of its sides are perpendicular. That is side A, okay, side A, and also side B. This forms a right angle of 90 degrees. That makes this triangle a right triangle. It has three sides, A, B, C, but the two sides, A and B, are perpendicular, forming a 90 degree angle. And so, the side of this triangle, which is side C, that is opposite to this 90 degree angle, is what we call the hypotenuse. So that is the hypotenuse of this triangle. And the sides A and B are called the legs of this triangle. And depending on which angle we are going to look at, either theta or alpha, we can name A and B with their appropriate name. So we are going to see this in the next coming videos when we are doing trigonometry. So a quick recap here is that a right triangle is any triangle, okay, that has two of its sides perpendicular to each other, okay? So here we have a 90 degree angle, that is this corner, okay? And we can label the length of this side as A and the length of this side as B, okay? So the side that is opposite to this 90 degree angle forms our hypotenuse, okay? So C, which is our hypotenuse, all right? So basically, this is the right triangle, and we know any triangle would have three interior angles, and in this case, we have theta, we have alpha. So the sum of these interior angles must be equal to 180 degrees. Therefore, we can say 90 degrees plus alpha plus theta should be equal to 180 degrees, okay? And the length of the three sides are given as A, B, and C, all right? So basically, that is what we mean by a right triangle. Now let's look at the Pythagorean theorem. This is a fundamental principle in geometry that relates the three sides of a right triangle in the form C squared, that's the square of the hypotenuse, okay, is equal to the sum of the squares of the legs. Okay, so in this case, C squared would be equal to A squared plus B squared. All right, that is what we call the Pythagorean theorem. All right, so here we know our C to be the hypotenuse because it is the only side that is opposite to the 90 degree angle here, okay? And that is the right angle, and that is the reason why we call it the right triangle, okay? For now, let us not concentrate on these two angles, theta and then alpha, okay? So for now, we are only interested in how the three sides of this right angle triangle are related. In simple form, the Pythagorean theorem relates these three sides in this powerful equation. Okay, so again, the C, which is the length of the hypotenuse, or the hypotenuse, is the side that is opposite to the 90 degree angle. This, in a nutshell, is all what Pythagorean theorem is about. Now let's dive into an example. Given the triangle below, find the length of the side C. Okay, so we can see that we have a triangle. Is it a right triangle? Yes, because we do have two of its sides being perpendicular, which is side A and side B, that are perpendicular, forming a 90 degree angle. Okay, so this 90 degree angle is facing the side C, which is what we call the hypotenuse. Okay, so identifying this in the first place allows us to use the Pythagorean theorem to find the length of the unknown side C. Let's look at how to do it. So with the solution, I'll first draw my triangle. Okay, my right triangle. Just the same triangle. So I have A, side A, giving us 6.00 centimeters. So it's a length. Okay, it's a length. And then we are given side B as 4.00 centimeters. And then we are asked to determine the hypotenuse, which we don't know. All right. However, this is simplified for us using the Pythagorean theorem. Which says that the side C squared, that is the hypotenuse squared, is equal to A squared plus B squared. Okay, so all we need to do is plug in our values for A and B and evaluate this expression. So step by step, we go C squared would be equal to 6.00 centimeters squared plus 4.00 centimeters squared. Okay, so C, the length of the side C, is going to be square root of 52.0 centimeters squared. Okay, so when we evaluate this, C is going to be about 7.21 centimeters. Okay, and using the Pythagorean theorem, we just found the length of the hypotenuse C. All right, given that we know the length of the two legs of the right triangle. Great. Now let's move on to a physics application of Pythagorean theorem. So it is a tool that helps us to solve problems in physics. Example is in 2D motion. So let's look at an example of displacement in 2D motion. The problem is a man walks 3 meters to the east and then 4 meters north. What is the total displacement of the man? Okay, so here our solution will require that we draw this motion or displacement of the man. Okay, so if I set my origin from here, this would be the north, all right? This would be the east, west, and then south, okay? So in this case, I can say if the man started here and then went 3 meters east, so 3 meters east, that gives me this side, 3 meters east, and then from there, walks 4 meters north. Okay, 4 meters north. So 4 meters here north. Now we can see the displacement or the resultant displacement. The total displacement is going to be that way. All right. If we refer to the graphical addition of vectors, it is going to lead to the same results. Okay. So now we can see we have the first east and north directions are perpendicular, so that forms a 90 degree angle, that is a right triangle. Okay, Next, what we have to do is to determine the length of the hypotenuse, because that is the resultant or the total displacement of this man. So let's label that as C. Okay, so applying Pythagorean theorem, we can say applying the Pythagorean theorem, that is C squared equals A squared plus B squared. All right. So that will give us C squared equals 3 meters all squared plus 4 meters all squared. Okay. So C is going to be square root of 25 meters squared. And that is equal to 5 meters. All right. So the total displacement of this man from the origin, okay, from the origin is 5 meters. All right. That's it. Very simple and easy to apply this to solve displacement in 2D motion. Another example I want us to look at is also in physics, okay? So another physics application of this Pythagorean theorem is finding the resultant velocity, okay? So we have another problem where we are imagining a delivery truck moving at 10 meters per second to the north and then 6 meters per second east. What is the truck's resultant velocity? All right, so what we can do here is, again, set the direction or the coordinates. So we have our north there. So if we start here as the origin, and then this says the truck moved at a certain speed or velocity in a certain direction. So in this case, in the north direction, the truck went 10 meters per second. All right, and then it went east. So east is that way. It went 6 meters per second. We can clearly see this 10 meters per second vector and the 6 meters per second vector are perpendicular, forming a right angle. And therefore, the resultant is going to be the hypotenuse from the origin to the end point. Okay. So we label that as our C, and then we can apply our C squared equals A squared plus B squared. Okay, so C is going to be square root of 10 meters per second squared, okay, plus 6 meters per second also squared. All right, and then evaluating this is going to give us about 12 meters per second, taking into account the number of significant figures. All right, so the truck's total or resultant velocity is just 12 meters per second. This is just simple as that. Okay, and if you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe to this channel for more videos on general physics lessons.